Hello, Patrick Walchuk here. Happy 2023. And as we typically do, we're going to look at the forecast or prediction for real estate in Ottawa for 2023. And we're filming this, by the way, on January 6th. So let's take a look at what we think might happen. So starting off with some major institutions and what their predictions are, not mine, okay? So CMHC, it was difficult to get something that wasn't a little on the older side, so this is the best we could do. So the last information we had is that they said that for this year, unit sales are going to be about 19,150 or down about 2%. For 2023 compared to 2022. So CMHC unit sales down, and they're saying the prices will be up by about 3.5%, okay? Now ReMax, our company, I couldn't get an exact price, but what they're saying is that units will be up about 1.5%. So that's a little bit in contradiction to CMHC. And they're saying the prices will be up about 4%. So that's kind of in line with CMHC. And then we look at another large real estate company, Royal Lepage. They're saying the average price will be up about 2% compared to 2022. So that's a little bit lower than REMAX's prediction, CMHC. So let's go on to the next slide. So looking ahead, I think that in the last two-thirds of, the last two-thirds of 2022 was a correction of the pandemic excesses that we looked at with prices going stratospheric for January, February, March, okay? Now, number two, the correction that we have been experiencing in the last basically 9 months of the year, that'll continue, but it's going to moderate, especially in the second half of this year. Now, the Bank of Canada is expected to raise interest rates by anywhere from 0.5 to 1%, and that'll happen likely in the first quarter of this year. Now, in the first half of 2023, this will be interesting. In my mind, we're going to have two opposing forces going on here. You know, in the first half of the year, that's traditionally a busy spring market when sales and prices are on the upswing. However, we're going to have those buyers who are going to be struggling with increasing mortgage rates versus that spring market. So who's going to win out? We'll see what happens there. That's something to keep our eye on. Now, number five, expect the unexpected. We found that out, boy, Delta, Omicron, and are there other variants that are going on? You know, about supply chain issues that we've read about. The Russia-Ukraine war is still ongoing with no end in sight. You hear about possible invasion of Taiwan by China, and Taiwan's got major manufacturing plants of chips for all sorts of electronics, including vehicles, computers, that kind of thing. Will that take place? And oh my gosh, if that does, watch out. So here's kind of the bottom line about this is if you can't influence it, or take precautions against something, then don't worry about it. I'm not making any predictions per se. You know, I'm just basically going to roll with the punches. I can't control this. So what I think is going to happen, bottom line, is it's going to be a bit of a bumpy ride for the first half of the year as the interest rates go up when the Bank of Canada raises them. And I think there will be some stability in the second half of the year. We'll see prices or units up or down 1 or 2%, no big deal either way. But that stability is key, and I don't think that interest rates are going to go down at all. And they will probably go down a little bit in the following year. That's the only prediction I'm making. Thank you for watching.